about it, because then got to lots of formulations problematic, and so what people did was to actually start engaging drugs to respond to corresponding patients. All right. Can you hear me? So, alright, so last time we discussed very general terms and abstract terms, also presented the symmetry on curve manifold, and today I would like to start presenting a complete example with the equation of how it works. And this will be an example in two dimensions. So, okay, we'll get discussing it. Specific of curve manifolds, and I would like to discuss one example. This is two dimensional series, 2.2 supersymmetry. And so I will discuss one specific example. Of course, different dimensionality, different amount of supersymmetry, different details, so that's the one. And one of these would be a setup where all my other examples are really, so this would be useful later on as well. So on the length of signature, it means, the amount of supersymmetry means that there are two left moving myronic charges and two right moving. Is supersymmetry algebra, I mean some asymmetry, which is not a symmetry of the, is not part of the algebra, it's an outer automorphism of the algebra. The maximal asymmetry that you can have is two copies of U1. One is vector-like, one is axial, so one gives the same charge. The vector-like gives charges plus one minus one, and the axial gives the same charge plus charges. However, it is not part of the supersymmetry algebra, it's just an outer automorphism, and so a supersymmetric theory does not need to have the supersymmetry asymmetry. However, I would like to consider a theory that has this asymmetry. So I require that this symmetry is asymmetry there, and it is not necessarily there. I mean, not necessarily. And so if we go to Euclidean, well, on fresh space, the algebra looks like the following. We have momentum. Then it turns out that this supersymmetry algebra has central charges. I think with this asymmetry, we can have a complex central charge. So this is momentum, these are the projectors on positive chirality and negative chirality. And here I'm in Euclidean signature, so all the fields are complexified. If I show it if I was in Lorentzian, this field would be a bar, this would be the complex conjugate of this, but in Euclidean signature is not the case. Getting for the central charges, this would be the complex conjugate of this, but in Euclidean is not. And everywhere I will now use tildes, and if you remember the tildes for these are the complex conjugate in Lorentzian and not in Euclidean. Okay. Moreover, we insist on having this example that is asymmetry, and so the supercharges are charges minus one. There are the central charges, but the physical central charges are charges commute with the supersymmetries, so the supersymmetry supercharges are not charged under the central charges. Alright, so now we want to take the theories and study how it happens when we try to put them on our control. And because we are insisting on the fact that the theory has this vector-like asymmetry, well, in the theory will exist the R matrix, so we don't use the most general F matrix, but this is more than one. And well, what is the R matrix in this specific example? Oh, okay, so there is a current sensor, supersymmetry current, and it's complicated. And then well, we have R charge, we have central charge, so we have HP. So we have current operators of them. There is the R symmetry current. And this is all we have. And of course, that is concerned, specific academic is concerned, but also these are conserved currents. Okay, so, well, there is, there exists a two dimensional supergravity with an offset formulation, which can be coupled to the R matrix. It is essentially the dimensional reduction of minimal supergravity, new minimal supergravity in four dimensions, and what is supergravity from supergravity to supergravity multiple. And what is the current multiplex, where we have a positive metric, where we have a positive latino, conjugate. And then here we have conserved current, so here we have, in fact, the case field. So case field comes to the asymmetry, and case field comes to the and here I'm using some notation in which, well, this is a real vector field, but the entities are complex, so the central charge is complex. We could just divide them into the real imaginary part and take it back to the okay, so Verdoux is a field that is a field, but of course they are very covariant derivatives. So for instance, if we have a generic field phi, answers, and massages, and we apply providing the relative, providing the relative. We contain the speed of the answers, and same thing for the other one, since I'm using some complex notation. This looks like a bit unusual, but one can again decompose the imaginary part of the charges and case speed again. Okay, so now the first thing we need is gravitational variation in this programming theory. The gravitino is only the 90s in this matrix, so then we want to impose the same, the only thing that we set to zero. So we set to zero the gravitino, and we set to zero the variation of the gravitino.
Along this vector, which is what we will have on the space,
No, we have a connection. But it, again, it's queue is a magic interface. This looks like my topology. So it depends on the background charges, depends on the app charges, depends on the background that is the field case will take. And as I said, in general, it's linear, you can see that field, so the connection is linear. And well, you also have the two field the same app charges, zero, and the same thing for the field as well. Okay. So, so if we could start studying the more general solution to these equations, I don't want to do that, we can go some references to that they gave you yesterday. I just want to point out some key solutions that will be important for us later. So, I think that is here, so I can give this. So what is the solution? So let's take a compact, first of all. Let's take some compact.
Thank you.